Started.
Hi there, episode 159 of the so-called podcast. This is going to be a pretty unusual one today because we've gone out in the wild to see this gargantuan waste of money that is the man. The only object in London which is named after slang for a part of the female body. £6 million worth of shite. Let's have a look at this, shall we?
Okay, so here we go. There are 122 steps on this as we go. Oh, it's brilliant. Yes, absolutely. By the way, the staff are fantastic. Did you hear that? Yep, so the staff have told us to make sure it's all good. There are the man rules. So if you're visiting, make sure that you don't carry children on your shoulders.
It does not exclude adults.
Carrying him. That's my brother, by the way. Keep to the pathway. Don't smoke. Don't vape. Don't have fun. Don't smile. No red meat. Respect the space of others around you. Stay back, much like British people. Stay away and keep your belongings with you at all time. My brother is with me. However, I don't own him, so I can't keep control of him. If he interjects, I will kick him. So we're going up the steps here. You can see that's the view so far, 122 steps all the way up, and as you can see, these are lovely steel corrugated steps, lots of holes in. Apparently dogs don't like walking up these type of steps because they've got slats between. Now, according to, I think it's Hot Fuzz or Spaced, dogs don't like slatted stairs, so the easiest way to confuse a dog is to get it to go up these steps. I don't know how true that is. I'm kind of guessing. So, by the way, I should point out, I'm a middle-aged man of exceptional girth and size. I don't tend to do this much walking, and definitely not when I'm talking. So if I sound like I'm out of breath, I thought I was getting fitter. No, just fatter. Which is not strictly true. Let's have a quick look here, halfway point. And there you go. There's a bus stop. Some Londoners. All right, mate, Cockney geezer, call blimey, cuff your knees up. And a corner. This is near Marble Arch, by the way. Hyde Park, through those trees. If you have incredible vision, you can see Hyde Park, the site of such fantastic rock concerts as Adele next summer at £570, and Pink Floyd at Live 8 16 years ago for £1.50 for a text message. I preferred the Pink Floyd one. In case of fire, break glass. More steps. Here we go. Obviously, this is not me talking about my records or a band or anything like that. This is me talking about something that's not particularly amazing. This is the view. Ah, more Hyde Park, way over in the distance. An office block. How exciting. I think that's Notting Hill, actually. And somewhere around about there is the hotel where Richie Manick stayed the night before he disappeared. That's right. Come for the geekery, stay for the Manick's facts. Here is a tree. I suspect this tree hasn't grown naturally in the time the mound has been here. I suspect it has been planted. Oh, look, in a pot. Yes, pre-graded. Right, so we're back into the trees. And here's the last of the 122 steps all the way up. Right, so there are a heck of a lot more people here than there were the last time I went up here. So this is the view from the top. Here's some barriers, presumably safety barriers. I mean, this place is pretty depressing, but I don't think it's actually life-threateningly depressing. It is career threatening if you happen to be a councillor from Westminster Council. They originally budgeted this astonishing waste of time at £2 million. It then came in as a staggering £6 million for the final cost of it, which, with using my professional abilities, I can tell you will have breached the OGU legislation and regulations, and therefore this mound is actually illegal and is a regulatory breach. Because of the cost. If the cost of building works is over £4.6 million, it should have been fully completed, and it probably wasn't. There's Oxford Street, one of the views that they'd like you to know about when you visit here. Here's a view of some shops. Here's a view of trees in pots and some buses. Right, let's go and see what else there is around here. Not very much, I imagine. we go. Here's another view. Oh look, these are some hotels, rich people's houses. And over here we have the London Eye. It's that thing there that looks suspiciously not like an eye. Slightly to the left of it, one of my favourite buildings in the world, 188 Kirtling Street, Battersea Power Station. I would love to have a life-size replica of that in my mansion, but I first need a mansion, then planning permission, so I possibly won't get it. So there you are. And then there's again another view of Hyde Park. So this is what you get for your £6 million. You get a mound and you get a fantastic steel walkway that is in no way comfortable, presumably shot through with holes here, because holes are considerably cheaper than, like, you remember when they used to sell, one of the reasons that they did polos was so they could make more money by putting a hole in it, and they made it hole. This is like the polo tower. It's basically all made of holes. And somewhere at the bottom, they will sell you a box of polo holes, which is actually the steel bits. Right, nearly finished. Let's go and have a look at the other bits over here. So this huge mound, I have forgotten to see how tall it is. It is slightly taller than Marble Arch. Oh, I haven't shown you Marble Arch. Right, so this is Marble Arch. There, that's Marble Arch there. That probably cost less than £6 million and is still here about 200 years later. The mound so far has been open approximately 2 months. The original idea was to open it and charge people £8 or £20 for 4 adults to visit in a group. If you have 3 friends plus yourself, I know that's a bit of a leap for me. You could have got in at the bargain price of £5, which is obviously nowhere near what it costs Westminster Council, because it costs them £6 million. There are 122 steps on here. Each one of these steps costs the equivalent of £49,587.46, which is, by the way, that's not the sound of the police coming to get the contractors who did a criminal job on this, by the way. So let's go down some stairs. Don't bother counting them, I did it on the way down. I've already done a test, Ricky. Oh, I found the squeaky one. Do you know?
The squeaky one.
Yes, they'll charge us more for the squeaky one. And if you look through here, look at that. This is what your £6 million gets you. It gets you fabric, it gets you wood, it gets you a plant,
a tree in a pot.
A tree in a pot that's weighted down by some load-bearing bricks in case the tree decides to escape or jump off because it's so fucking depressed being here.
My suspicions are correct.
Which are?
That is not a natural tree. That has actually been planted. It is a fake tree.
It is a real tree. It's a real actual tree. It just happens to not be planted in the ground.
This is quite right.
Not a plastic tree.
Also buys you a lot of scaffolding.
Yeah, so this is the inside here. 122 steps on the way down, ladies and jelly spoons. As I've said before, 49,500 and something pounds per step, the equivalent being approximately 2 times the national median salary in the United Kingdom. This was paid for by taxpayers, which means if you are paying tax, this is the equivalent of the median tax burden for probably hundreds of people. In fact, no, definitely hundreds of people, very possibly 1,000 people. And it was paid for by Westminster Council, who originally put a budget estimate in of £2 million, and they woefully got it wrong. I think the councillor that's responsible for it has now resigned, and I don't mean resigned in a way that indicate that they've become accepting of their terrible, terrible fate. They have left the job. Of course, if you're in the private sector and a job like this costs £6 million instead of £2 million, you would be fired, but here you're not. By the way, if you look all the way down there, you can see what looks to be a pink plastic bear and a sign saying I love London, alongside a pink panda, a plastic panda, and a panda plastic tiger. There you go, plastic tiger, all the way down there in the depths. This is what your £6 million gets you. And you wonder why people say the public sector is flabby. Of course, some of the people that work in the public sector who literally cannot get jobs anywhere else, including the financial vampires of Boris Johnson and Jacob Rees-Mogg are MPs because you can't be sacked as an MP. And in fact, they've very recently changed the rules to make sure you can't be sacked as an MP. You can only fall on your sword as the whatever the weird character is in Flash Gordon who sacrifices his life to Ming the Merciless. I have nothing. No, it's not Prince Voltan. Prince Voltan's another chap. Prince Voltan is Timothy Dalton, I believe. So there you go. There's your pink pig. There's your cardboard tiger. And your paper panther. All loving London, but banished into dark place. Like characters in a Matt Berry television show. This was well worth your £6 million. I guarantee you I could make this better and cheaper with just sticky back plastic and some instructions downloaded from the Blue Peter website. This is a catastrophic waste of money. Hi there. There you go. And there's again, those are. Oh, of course, yes, sorry. Yep, that was step 121. We are now inside a place of wonder, which is this. This is easily the best thing about it. It is a work of art by a chap, I think his name is Anthony James, who specializes in this type of thing. I know nothing about him. However, if you look at that, you might be, you know, not mistaken to think that it was something very science fiction-y indeed. In fact, my first thought when I saw this was either Tron or Vija from Star Trek The Motion Picture. If you look closely inside, I'd like to thank Brian Eno for bringing threatening music into it. It is a series of mirrors that are interlaced inside each other so that they all point inside each other so you can't see anybody else. So, for example, you can't see people standing in front of it, next to it, near it, or anything. It's all very science fiction-y, but it's not particularly good. And of course, you can go through here, and then that looks like, that very definitely looks like something out of Star Trek The Motion Picture. You'll find William Shatner trying to find his wig somewhere deep inside there. Here we go into another room, again, lots of threatening music. Isn't that lovely? Can you hear all of that? And it is a series of what looks to be 16 boxes, all covered in mirrors. Hooray! You're not meant to touch these things. People do touch them. Of course, here comes yet another scary object. This is very science fiction-y indeed. What an enormous waste of money it was. £6 million. But it's very, very impressive. You get a little bit closer to it. Poke your face right up there. Whoa, my God, it's full of stars. You can tell why I didn't get the role in 2001. It isn't in what looks to be steel, mirrors and lights. It's all, what is it, smoke and mirrors. Here's a threatening, not at all a threatening silhouette there for you. And I think we have to find our way out now. It's through here, isn't it? Excellent. So that was your £6 million taxpayers. Yeah, and this was under a Conservative council who like to think that they bring the best and the brightest of the public sector out. They don't. There you go, kids. That's your mound. That's £6 million worth of crap. Bye.